Hi, everybody. Welcome to Toronto, Ontario. Along with Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski. Should be an intriguing one tonight, Razor. It's a little east side versus west side.
Yeah, they don't happen very often anymore the way the schedules are, so you get to see players from the other conference. Some of the best players will come in and play, and it becomes like a real extra special event.
Well, the moment of truth is almost upon us here. They are about to drop the puck. The Leafs start with possession as we are now underway. Minnesota's got possession of the puck. The Leafs get a hold of the puck. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. Right to the middle, denies them in close. Tries to get the puck over to Zuccarello. Fires it into the offensive zone. And that pass can't connect. Delayed penalty coming up here by the official. Trying to engage a little physicality here. And the whistle stops the play. And someone's off to the box. Boarding the call on the play.
Judgment call always for the official. Is it okay to make the play? Or is he a little overzealous, which is what he was called there?
Marner's out here for the power play, guys. We know he's got that zone ability, and it could be a weapon here as they try to get on the board with the special teams.
Toronto's won the draw, and they'll go to work. Oh, what a save in front!
Whoa!
He scores!
Ah, the power play comes through. They move the puck nicely, and they're able to capitalize on the extra man. Power play's job is to create shots, and if you can create them from the most dangerous areas of the ice, you're going to be successful. Dead center, in the slot, he doesn't miss.
That was incredible stick handling to get by and score, and that's his puck on a string superstar ability. You could tell all of his hard work at practice finally paid off, and wow, what a goal.
Puck grab by Spurgeon. Quick pass to Zuccarello. With the glove by Campbell.
And by number 88. Time of the goal. 1 minute, 15
lots of time
seconds
left in this period. 1-0 the score. Locks him up on the draw. He scores! They tie it up!
They've been working hard to get this game back to level. And that goal will do it. Goalie just can't keep up with this. He's close to the net, but he's still able to have enough room to beat the goaltender.
The Leafs win possession here in the open ice. Oh, devastating collision lined up in the railroad tracks. Minnesota's got it across the line. The Leafs have it now. Moves it to Mikheyev. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. And he regains control of the puck. He scores! And the deadlock's been broken!
Now you get a chance to control the pace of the game. It's tough to do it in a tie game. Now you've got the lead. You can come to the rink a lot of nights and not see stuff as beautiful as this. Man, does he dangle his way through the defenders. They're grasping for air. There's nobody there. He's behind them now, and it's in the net.
He knew exactly how he wanted to score, and he used his superstar ability to make it happen. Talk about being dialed in tonight, guys.
Puck picked up by Spurgeon. And a nice takeaway in the defensive end by Marner.
The Leafs have continually put themselves in good positions defensively tonight. It seems like every shift they're stealing a puck. Oh, look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here.
And now it's over to Mikheyev. And just a good old-fashioned solid body check on the play. Penalty coming up here as the play is stopped. The Wild have been handed a 2-minute penalty for holding.
He's going to see this on the big board once he sits down. He'll see this as a penalty.
Matthews has a chance to contribute on the power play here. His zone ability is something he can pull out of his toolbox, use to his advantage, and hopefully help the team score.
Sturms want a big draw on their own end. Good battle along the boards for the puck. Takes the pass. Denied by the goaltender. A chance from the slot. Oh, and another save.
Quick reflexes give him the opportunity to make back-to-back stops.
Huge hit on the play. Slides it over to Sturm. A chance. That's turned away with the pad by Campbell. Puck exits the zone. Pass to Kulikov. Great defensive play at center by Kasha. Toronto's gained possession along the boards. Good defensive effort to poke it away. Oh, and I'm sure they'd like a redo on that.
Now, lots of work and nothing for it as they don't get the puck on goal.
Moves the puck. Move to the middle. And that one's broken up. Great block there. Sends the pass over. And the man advantage fails to pay off as both teams are back at even strength.
Oh, man, what a good power play, but it doesn't change the big numbers up on the score clock. Couldn't score, but all kinds of chances.
Centering pass, and they can't connect. Oh, he got all of that. What a save by Kähkönen.
Stretched all the way out, just gets a piece of it to keep it out of the net.
Inching closer to the midway mark of this period. Toronto's up 2-1, and the crowd has been enjoying this one. Sneaks away with the puck after he was tangled up on the draw. Here's a chance behind the net. That goes off a twig. Minnesota's got the puck along the wall. Slides the pass over to Kaprizov. Quick feed to Tavares. Here's a shot. Scores right on the doorstep. He pounces on the rebound and puts it home.
Goalie burps up this rebound here. It comes right back into the shooting area and the rebound is put away.
Teams are lined up, and we are ready to take this draw. Slides in off the wing after the centerman tied him up. Takes a hit on the play. Drives to the crease. Oh, it cuts up with nothing on the play.
Tavares receives the puck. Now he's a dangerous guy. He's got two goals already.
That pass doesn't go. Play whistle dead because of an offside. More than half the frame has been played here. The Leafs have recently taken a two-goal lead. They'd love to build on it. Toronto's won the draw. Takes the feed. Oh, that sounded like a car crash. Slides it back to the blue line. And they won't connect on that one. Handles the puck. Receives the pass. Makes it look easy with the stop. Moves it quickly over to Foligno. Snaps one on net. Stopped by the goaltender. Campbell's going to cover it up and get a whistle.
Even with the traffic starting to close in, he had to grab that when he did. The shooter knows right away, James, that this isn't a very good shot. It's a good scoring chance that's not executed well. And for the rest of your shift, you're skating around thinking, I could have done better with that.
Toronto's won the faceoff deep in their own end. Slides the puck over. The Wild have it in their own zone. Takes the feed from his own end. Here's a shot. Denies him with the pad. The Leafs will play it through the neutral zone. Here's a short pass to Nylander. Turn that one aside.
Kähkönen's able to make the save look really easy. Now he doesn't have to deal with the rebound either.
sends it in on the attack. Takes the feed. The Leafs take it across the blue line. Can't connect on the pass. The Wild have taken possession along the wall. Snaps it on net. Big time stop. And now he moves it to Goudreau. They've got some momentum here. Sends it over and makes the save. Picked up along the wall by Goudreau. Sends a pass over. Cutting to the front of the net. Puck scooped up by Kerfoot. Quick pass to Brody. And now he moves it quickly to Muzzin. Nice pass.
And things starting to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play.
Moves it to Goudreau. Comes up with the stop. Slides the puck to Kerfoot. The Leafs take it along the wall. There's the whistle from the linesman calling it offside. Late goings of this period. Toronto's got a 3-1 lead. Matthews wins it in the neutral zone. Takes the pass. The Wild have the puck in their own zone. Greenway's got it against the boards. Bunting's got it behind the cage. Along the wing up the neutral zone. To the low slot. Here he is in front. Stopped by the goaltender.
Excellent chance. They work the puck into position, and it's a scoring chance. It's turned away.
The Leafs gain possession. Slides the puck to Matthews. The Leafs will play it from the defensive zone. Looking dangerous as they move along the boards. And puts the body into it, a little bumper car hockey. From the right side, they gain the zone. There's the whistle. Offside is the call, stopping the play.
That's a pretty good save, James. Just a piece, and I guess enough to keep it out of the net.
And both centers glide into the dot as a face-off set to resume. Hartman's won possession. And that pass attempt is deflected. Moves the puck. Sends the pass over. There's the whistle. Offside is the call. They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. Horn sounds, bringing an end to what has been a pretty fun start to this one.
Be sure to get next year's season tickets now. This year's locations and prices will now pay extra for the first three rounds of the playoffs. This offer is available now. Don't miss your opportunity to pick up the best locations.
And as both teams head to their respective rooms, two more periods still to come. We're looking forward to it here on EA Sports. Both teams back on the ice, they're lined up, and period number two is about ready to go. Here we go, middle frame now underway as the puck drops. Smart heads up play to neutralize the threat. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Zuccarello. Takes the feed. I don't know where that was going. Oh,
James, that was so wide. You see the look on his face? He can't believe he missed the net by that much.
Uses the force on that hit. Carries it across the line. And now he angles it across to Spurgeon. And that banks off a stick. And it's a quick pass to Zuccarello. Moves inside. He scores! What a goal!
Oh, we can see on the replay here, the goalie just gets a little piece of his shot, not near enough. It's in the net.
Minnesota's back to center ice, and now it is just a deficit of one.
What a difference just the one goal makes in the way that you look at the game, what makes you think is possible. They only need one more to even this up.
The Wild have gained control of the puck along the wall. Foligno's got it across the line. Wrist shot from the slot. That's blocked away. Oh, another consecutive stop.
Oh, he's locked right in. A couple of stops in a row there.
Handles the puck. Big chest save as he gobbled that one up with the trapper.
Bunting's got to know right before he takes this hit that he's going to get run over.
James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. Minnesota's shown a new energy over these last few minutes. They got one back, but they still need one more in order to tie. Now a quick pass to Foligno. Things start to get a little physical out there. The Leafs gain possession in their own end. Makes a move and the puck hops away from him.
Sometimes trying a little bit too much is just no good for anybody. That play gets broken up.
And he makes the save on that play. And now he tries to get it across to Mikheyev. Moves it around along the half wall. From the slot, wrist shot. Zero fear on this guy's part as he blocks it. Into the attacking area from the left side. Oh, he stops him with the glove. Great reflexes there. Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. Toronto's hanging on to this 3-2 lead. Rossi's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. Scrum ensues along the boards. Toronto's got it in their own zone. And now it's over to Kerfoot. The Leafs take it along the wall. Receives the pass. And too much traffic in front blocks that one. And that's turned aside. Slides the puck over. Takes the feed. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. Beautiful read in the defensive end by Nylander.
Toronto's read the play just perfectly tonight. It's like they have the book of the way the game is going to be played. Every time there is a moment of space that's available, they seem to shut it off.
Sends a pass over. Quick feed to Zuccarello. He scores! They tie it up! They stayed with it the entire time, Ray!
I'm tired of listening to coaches talk about, oh, we followed the process, but the process is you don't get frustrated, you keep chipping away, and you hope to get to this point. He pounded this low stick side. The goalie can't get his pad on it. It's in the net.
Centers glide into the dot as a faceoff ready to resume play. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Riley's got it along the wing.
Wow.
They score! Ray, I don't know how many times we've traveled around. You always talk about it's better to play in front.
Well, you break the deadlock here, James. Now you get out in front. You can dictate the pace of the game. Pretty tough for the goaltender to go two ways. He thinks he's moving to the puck, but it hits the defender and goes in the net.
Toronto's jumped out to a one-goal lead here in the second.
Breaking the tie was critical. Now you can play in front and try and dictate the pace of the game.
Passes it to Zuccarello. Looking to make something happen along the boards. And that's deflected. He'll probably feel that one tomorrow.
2 minutes, 24 seconds.
Nearing the midway mark of the period. The Leafs are hanging on to this one goal lead. They'd love to add another. Matthews wins the draw on their own end. Minnesota's got a hold of the puck now. Quick shot! How did he stop that one?
I like how he was able to follow the puck. Good save in close. Campbell's probably had a few saves tonight he's felt better about than that one, but he got just enough of it to keep it out of the net.
Past the midway mark in this period, this one has been a good back and forth contest. We're sitting with a 4-3 hockey game. Brody's lugging the puck, and now he moves it to Kasha.
Matthews collects the puck in the offensive zone. His last goal put them in front.
Spurgeon swooping in on the attack. There's a hit on the play. Matthews setting up against the wall. Wicked stop by the goalie who got his glove out to knock it away. Taken by Eriksson Ek. Nothing.
You don't get the puck dead center very often. He's got to capitalize.
You wonder if that'll come back to haunt them. Moves up near the blue line and looks to set up at the point. And he slides it quickly to Brodin. Lets it fly. Hello! All tied up with a goal!
Really good play to score and to get this game back to even. Now we'll see who can grab momentum. Oh, man, you can feel this coming. The pressure of this forecheck, the relentless pursuit of the puck. Eventually, it's either a penalty or a goal. In this case, it's in the net and it's on the board.
Officials are in position, and both teams are getting ready as they get set for another face-off here. And play resumes as the puck is dropped. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Mikheyev. Takes a shot, and a great save! Toronto's got the puck against the half wall. Right in the slot! Gets a piece of it with the glove! Oh, a little cat burglar-like play with the stick. Nicely done. Puck has covered it up, and the officials will finally whistle the play dead here, Razor.
You almost, if you're on the ice, you look at the ref and you're like, what took you so long? They're exhausted, under pressure here in their zone. They finally get a stoppage.
Past the midway mark of the frame, James and Ray with you tonight. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Minnesota's won the draw. Brodin stick handling in his own zone. Stays with it. Nice pass. Errant pass, and they can't connect. And no luck on that pass attempt. They fight for it along the boards. And now it's grabbed by Eriksson Ek. Minnesota's got the puck against the boards. Manages to hang on. Moves the puck down low. Moves it quickly over. Scores!
The deadlock's broken. That's a big goal, and they put him into the lead. Goalie gets a little bit of this, almost beat cleanly, but it's not going to matter. It's in the net anyway.
The Wild have the luxury of playing with the lead now as we approach the second intermission.
It was starting to look like it was going to be locked up going into the second intermission. This is a huge goal for them and gives them a position if they can get into the intermission to control the third period.
And they fail to go take to take. Feeds it down low. Unable to reach that one. And now he angles it across to Goligoski. Denies him! He got all of it! And the puck's knocked loose. There's another for the hit parade. Puck grabbed by Dermott. Across the line. And the intensity's starting to ramp up here after that hit. And now he tries to get it across to Riley. Look out! Stones him in front. Kakinen's going to hang on to that one for a whistle.
Quickly on top of that, James. He needed a cover there.
In the final moments of this period, Minnesota's got a one-goal lead. Matthews has won the faceoff. And the traffic neutralizes that threat. And that somehow stayed out of the net. From the back of the cage with the puck. Minnesota's got one last chance to make something happen before the end of the period. Centered out in front. Oh, pokes it away. Gutsy movement. It pays off. And he hangs on just as time runs out. Well, not exactly a banner night for the goaltenders as the second period comes to an end. At least they'll get a breather here.
As well as email notifications on upcoming promotions and exclusive fan club member events.
Third period is just around the corner, so don't even think about putting that controller down. Two down, one to go. Third period, they're ready to drop the puck. It's been a throwback to 80s hockey here, and we are underway here in the third. Ray Ferraro is between the benches at ice level. Ray, we've got 40 minutes played so far. How have you viewed things?
Minnesota's ahead in this high chance, high danger game. No use changing the way you're going to play now.
Goligoski's carrying it ahead. Offside is the call, and we'll have a faceoff just outside the offensive zone. Still plenty of time left in this frame. 9 goals and counting so far. It's 5-4. Faceoff here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. And now it's over to Kasha. Toronto's in transition. Here we go, one-man rush. And that's broken up. Goligoski's moving it ahead. Minnesota's got it along the wall. Toronto's got the puck in the defensive end. And now he moves it to Ponting.
Mikheyev's back on the ice here. He's had a big night offensively. He's got a couple of points so far.
And serves up a little knock on the play. Erickson X exploring options with the puck. The Leafs scoop it up along the boards. Trying to engage a little physicality here. Made the save on the play. Takes the pass.
Mikheyev's been a leader of this team offensively, and tonight he's really at the front of the line. 3 points already.
Moves the puck. He scores! Jumps all over his rebound! Puts it in.
Man, his teammate could get rich with passes like this. What a move that opens up everybody. And then he lays off a simple one for him.
Minnesota's now up by 2 in this third.
Terrific start to the period. They're up 1 and they don't sit back. You know I love that, James. Get after it.
Fires it into the offensive zone.
Assisted by number 36.
Feeds the puck up to Erickson Ek. He's got a step. And I'm not quite sure what the hope was on that.
James, you said it. He was in all alone. Now he's going to skate out all alone because he doesn't get anything out of that breakaway attempt.
Hey, if you could rerun that hit was big. Everybody likes a clean hit. Watch how solidly he goes through, makes the contact there. That's a big hit.
Teams are ready for the draw. The linesman about to drop the puck. Toronto's got a hold of the puck. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Mikheyev. Laying the body. Grabbed along the board by Rossi. Sends it deep inside the offensive zone. Puck picked up by Matthews. Sends the pass over. Kasha's got it into offensive territory. He clearly doesn't like that.
Spurgeon's looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else. They're going to have to look at him immediately. He's just slowly working his way to the bench, James.
Kakinen's going to opt for the whistle and give everybody a chance to breathe.
Sometimes you get running around as the shift gets long. This helps.
That one stung, and he's slow to get himself back together here, James. I want to look at that again.
Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Oh, what a stop by Kakinen! Kakinen's on top of the puck, and that'll stop the play.
Pretty conservative play here, James, as he covers it up to kill the play. Kakinen's on top of this. That's an enormous stop on a scoring chance.
Well, that's one way to win the draw as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. There's the whistle, and a penalty is coming up on this one. Spurgeon's called for tripping. He's off to the box.
Reaching for the puck, trying to be in position. You're just a little bit away, and then you get nabbed for tripping.
Yeah, it's always tough to use the I got stuck excuse, right?
Never works.
Toronto's power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work.
It's kind of nice if you have a power play goal already in the game, which they do. Make sure the confidence continues to build and you try and get another.
Oh, what a stop by Kakinen!
They work the puck into a scoring spot, get a pretty good chance on goal. They just can't find a way to finish it off.
Grabs the puck and moves on out here with this man advantage. Moves it to Ponting. Here's a shot and makes a save. Takes the puck as the clock ticks down on the penalty kill. And the puck clears the zone. Taken along the wall by Riley. Here's a short pass to Tavares. Nice pass back. Minnesota's got a hold of it against the wall. Picked up along the boards by Hartman. And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play. Gets it over to Spezza.
Every time you turn around, there's another goal. Your throat's got to be getting sore with all these goal calls. I love it. The more wild and unpredictable the game, the more fun it is for the fans to watch.
Riley's got it in the defensive end. Toronto's moving it into the offensive end. Moves the puck over to Hartman. Sent into the offensive zone. Toronto's got possession of the puck. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. Quick pass over to Goligoski. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Shot off a stick. Toronto's got the puck. Scooped up along the wall by Bunting. Through the neutral zone, up along the wing. Puck dumped in. Minnesota's got it in their own zone. Along the right wing, they enter the attacking area. Toronto's got the puck inside the defensive zone. And that's poked away by Kaprizov. Gaining momentum along the wing. Shot! And that's blocked away. Foligno's got the puck in his own zone. And now he angles it across to Kaprizov. Cuts into the paint! He scores! They might as well keep that light on behind the goaltender.
And again? That's four straight for them here. They have just totally taken over this game. You want to use the player in front of the net as a screen if you can. This time it's just about perfect. I don't think the goaltender ever picks it up.
The Wild have extended this lead. In these moments, do you want run time and just, you know, you've got it in the bag, or do you want to continue to pour it on here, Ray?
No, I think everybody wants one more cooker.
Oh. Minnesota's got the puck along the boards. Along the right side into the offensive zone. Here's a shot, and that one's turned away.
Campbell's really had a difficult time tonight. He's not looked comfortable. Even in warm-up, I thought he was a little bit shaky. He makes a good save there to keep his team somewhat in the game.
Here they come on the attack. The Leafs have it from their own end. Nice feed from the boards. And he slides it quickly to Greenway. And that's stopped by Campbell. Again, the denial by the goaltender. Campbell's on top of that one for a whistle.
Little bit of traffic starting to form around the net. Sometimes you pick up a little extra in the replay here, and as you look at this, the goalie is so sharp to make this save. That's an excellent shot that is taken, and the goalie turns it away.
The Leafs win the draw. Puck sent over to Nylander. Puts it in deep. Minnesota's got a hold of it along the wall. Quick pass to Fiala. Minnesota's got the puck along the wall. And he comes up with it. Picked up along the wall by Rossi. The Leafs have it now. Through the open ice, they're picking up steam. And as we hit the final minute of this one, that has been a one-sided affair. Denies him with the paddle save. Oh, they do it again. Denies him.
Really good positioning as he makes the stop from in tight.
Moves it to Brodin. Whacks it into the offensive zone. The Leafs gain control of the puck. Takes the feed.
And just a good old-fashioned solid body check on the play.
Moves the puck to the attacking area. Devastating collision into the boards. Oh, he'd like to have that pass back. Angles it over to Nylander. And now he tries to get it across to Spezza with the stop.
Save is good. Better yet, that rebound doesn't stay in front of the net. It's over to safety in the corner.
And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. 4 seconds. And that's all she wrote on this one as we are in the books.
Pretty good hockey game, and I guess they can say they did some good things, like they had a better face-off percentage, but not enough, James.
Is this sometimes a case, though, of the numbers lie?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, great, you won the face-offs. You didn't score enough.
On behalf of Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski. Thanks for joining us. Good night.